inside out, and we would spend years and generations and maybe more sorting it out. And you know, the only consolation I have is, well, if disclosure does occur, when it occurs, let's say, I'm not going to take the blame for it. I feel that whatever I desire or what we desire, we're just sort of players in this, and we're being taken along on a very, very powerful current. So I believe that's why I would say it's inevitable.
This is a question for Pierre Sabat. I'm an experiencer, and I'm often drawn to people's work through your experiences themselves. So I just wondered, in your case, Pierre, have you ever experienced any of the...
Yeah, I've had a number of different experiences. I'm going to sound probably crazy now, but I saw a shining being in my room, and it possessed me, and it made me bark like a dog. I'm beginning to understand some of the significance of that, because the dog symbolises the dog star. I also see that there's a correlation within the Arabic as well between Nabi, which is a prophet, and Naba, which is to bark. And again in Arabic, Allah and Allah. So that was an interesting experience. And that occurred when I started writing the book, The Murder of Realities and Symbolism of the Dragon, when I was 29 years old. So that was something that occurred. I've also seen shadow beings as well. And that was a very interesting experience, because I was talking to them, and they said that they'd come from the earth, which I took that to mean that they'd come from the center of the earth. And what was very interesting about the shadow beings is that they actually talk in rhyme. So they everything they said was in a rhyme. So it was very different from a normal type of discourse. And I actually wrote down some of this information. And I had another experience when I was sleeping. I was in France in Languedoc. And this, what basically happened was this cloud, this dark cloud, it descended upon me, and it tried to kill me. It was trying to suffocate me. And I swore at it. I said, get off me. But I literally swore at it. And it went straight to the corner of the room. I could instantly sense that it was afraid of me, that it was scared of me. And so, I suddenly realised that it tried to take off more than what it could actually handle. And I sensed this fear. So in a sense, the tables have been turned. So, there's a few experiences, and they're a little bit bizarre, they're a bit strange and surreal, but so there's a few.
Is that lady, did you have your hand up, madam? Blonde lady with the red cardigan? No. Okay. Only put your hand up if you want to ask a question. If I was an auctioneer, you'd lose £3,000 and get a carriage clock. Wow, this is especially quiet.
Could disclosure start covertly?
Sorry, I thought you had your hand up.
Yeah.
had discussions that reached cabinet level it's not clear to me that George Bush participated in them, and that disclosure was overruled. So I think this comes up. I had another individual who I would say is very well connected said, yeah, this comes up every 5 years or so. This is a question that is raised. And I don't know if it still is, but it has to be.
Probably the aliens might initiate the covert phase of it to begin with.
I don't know.
And just make people gradually come into the awareness of the
bigger
community.
I do not know. I don't know if anyone really knows that.
I'd just like to mention that this has been going on for thousands of years. It's not just, oh, well, it's just suddenly started in the 21st century. Because if we look at it, we've already had partial disclosure, and that partial disclosure is within the archaeological record,
mm-hmm.
within the symbols. So I think it's much more complex than that. But obviously, you know, this is part of a bigger pattern. This is going to lead to another part, another stage in man's evolution.
I think about more scientific awareness about how we came to be and the universe and that. And
I think, well, with the invention of the computer, we're already at year dot.
Yeah.
So we're seeing another massive intellectual expansion, a revolution almost. This, in a sense, this is a part of this revolution, this intellectual discourse.
Anyone else? Hands up. I fit on my milk, am I? I'll move you, sir. Thanks very much.
Is that close enough? Yeah, I feel very fearful of asking this question. I don't know if it's Mary that I should be talking to, but I thought I'll ask you guys if there's anyone who needs any advice. Lots of, I'm experienced, lots of strange things. I do Reiki and things like ayahuasca in Canberra a lot recently. Lots of experiences where I see things in my head and then they happen to me later on, you know, during the day. whatever you call that. Sometimes I feel like when I have an experience where I've really learned and understood something and my chakras are wide open, I've had feelings like I could just get beamed up, you know, if I just let go, I could just get beamed up somewhere, which is obviously frightening, so I just kind of try and ground myself. And if I'm at home during the day, if I'm on my own, I seem to just lose hours. You know what I mean? I'm not doing anything. I don't know what happens in those hours. I just seem to... I've got no recollection of them. So I did have a strong feeling that I should talk to Mary with a lot of the stuff that she was talking about yesterday, but also just like to ask any of you guys who've got any advice or places I can go online to find some answers or, you know, how to work with them.
I occasionally run come tattoo support sessions through the WBFA group website. So we hold an internet chat via the website. It's closed off, and you can talk directly with other come tattoos and experiences. So usually when we hold those, you find a lot of correlation between different cases. So you've got to talk with other people. And the premonitions thing, the thing you're talking about, is extremely common. In over half the cases I've looked into, and I've looked into about 200 or so far, that shows up as a very regular part of the contact experience, and the two are directly related. We don't fully understand the reason for that yet, but many, many experiences have one or more sixth sense type abilities. And the most common one that is reported to me is that premonitions, seeing things in advance before they happen. And it can often come in dreams, but also in the daytime, just sort of thoughts that will just come through like that. Absolutely. Yeah.
Thank you. What's the
Birmingham UFO group?
Yeah, website is bufog.com, bufog.com.
And Mary Rodwell has a website, and if you email Mary, she's very approachable, and she will reply to you. She'll talk to you on Skype and everything.
Yeah.
She's very good like that. We've got time for one more question.
Let me just answer the very, very simple pragmatic advice. And I'm not a therapist or a doctor or anything, but what because I get this question a lot, I would just say, keep a journal, write the stuff down, date the things, and organize the stuff in a written way. I found that it's as simple as it sounds, it's extremely beneficial.
Sorry, this is going to have to be the last question. I know some other people had their hands up. I'm sorry, it's a gentleman here. We've only got time for one more. Hi.
I just wanted to ask, if the power structures of planet Earth have been aware of this information, and whether it be extraterrestrial or interdimensional, whatever kind of intelligence we've been in contact with, why would the public disclosure be happening now or in the near future? I'm aware of this tendency in history that every generation seems to think that it's the most significant and Armageddon's just around the corner. What evidence or what reason do you think now is the time that this is all going to come out? I like to think it is. I'm just curious as to what your reasons would be.
I'm going to assume you're directing it toward me, so but maybe other people have no idea. I'll just jump in quickly and say that it's certainly true. Every generation in human history has typically felt that they're living in a special time. That includes our era, and that includes also the previous generation. That includes previous centuries and millennia. In the history of the UFO phenomenon, by the way, every single decade since the 1940s, there was always a group of people who felt that disclosure, even when they didn't use that word, the end of secrecy was likely to happen now. This is a constant threat. So you're absolutely right. I personally, I've always described disclosure as a paradox, which is that I describe it as impossible and inevitable. I've never seen a motivation for the power structure, those who have knowledge of this anyway, to give it up voluntarily. I see no benefit from them, from their position. But as I see it, they're not the only part of the equation. There are these other entities, whatever they are, and they may have an agenda, but I've always felt the dynamic part of the equation is us. And I would say that we actually are living in a qualitatively different era than any other time in the human past. If you just look at the long history of our civilization, pre-industrial era went for thousands and thousands and thousands of years. And it wasn't really until about 150 years ago that we started to transform ourselves. And it wasn't really until the last century that we really started to transform ourselves with electronics and communications technologies. And we're now at the point, if you think UFOs are weird, go read some books on the future of artificial intelligence. Those people are not fringe. They get a lot of grant money to do their work. And they are all, without exception, talking about the advent of the singularity, which computer intelligence will exceed our own, probably within, I don't know, 20 years, give or take. There's quantum computing down the road. There's advanced nanotech. There's advanced organic 3D printing. There's complete mastery of the human genome. All of this is happening now. It's right now. So you tell me if that doesn't portend a qualitative change, not only in the structure of our society, but our entire civilization, and very probably the nature of humanity itself. So in that kind of a situation, in which the leading edge of our collective intelligence is jumping up, it seems to me really, really unrealistic to assume that tomorrow is going to be like today, and we're not going to have any new insights into this phenomenon, and that something will probably force open, let's call it disclosure of some sort or another. That's why I think we're in a different era.
Ladies and gentlemen, our speakers. A special thank you to Anthony Beckett, who's both spoken, and he's helped organise this conference. He's the lead organiser of this conference. On camera, but they're essential to the running of this event. There's Nick, who does technicians. There's Rachel, there's Kirsty out on the front desk. There's Gary, our sheepdog, who's been rounding up the troops. There's everyone and everyone else involved. So big round of applause for everyone. Perhaps most of all, thanks to all of you for coming. Especially those who are here for the first time. I hope you've had your minds blown this weekend. So well done. Give yourself a big round of applause. next year. Right, and maybe next year we're going to pack our weapon, we'll see. See what happens. Get this closure for there.